Next problem, this is our front view, okay. So this is a very typical one. In the front view, you can able to see this entire surface, okay. First, we will draw this entire surface. So for that one, I will take a xy line and x1, y1 line. Then at a distance of 88, I will draw this line, okay. Then at a height of 24, a vertical line I will draw, okay, with reference to x1, y1. And at a distance of 12 mm, this length is 12. So 12 mm, I will draw one more line. Next, a vertical line, which is a height of 32, I will draw one more line. And then this line, a horizontal line of 32 again, here also, here they have represented it as 32. And a vertical line, which has to be get coincide at this surface. Okay, we don't know the dimension of this vertical line. We will just draw a line, or otherwise we can take this height as a 12 mm, okay, and then we can mix that particular line. So take this height as a 12 mm, and with this point you draw in, join a line, you can get meet up at this particular point, either or not you can draw in anyway. Next, this part, this 44 curve is not view into me, but I can able to see one straight line here, is it or not, like this. So that one I have to represent with a height of same 44, okay, or you make a reference with respect to this line, then join this line, okay, join this line, which will be having a 44. Now this part is visible to me, is it or not, side part, entire, this entire shape is visible to me. So first thing is a 6 mm line I have to draw. Next, at the bottom line, I have to draw 108 minus 88. Whatever the length will get, that length I have to draw here. Here, this length will be 108 minus 88. Then from this reference point, I will try to join a line here. Next, here there is a hole. No? This hole, we have to represent it here. That there is some kind of a semicircular hole. So I will take a dotted line at a distance of 20 mm from this surface. Since the hole is 40, that the center will be 20, so I can able to take from here to here as 20 mm and I have to draw a dotted line. And then I will try to join this line at the bottom surface also, like this. So this completes my front view. Then take the projections like this. After taking the projections, draw the top view. So for drawing the top view, take a line which is having a distance of 42 plus 32, so totally it will be 76 totally length. Then a vertical line, this 12 mm line, or we will go with extension of this 12 mm line, 12 mm. Next, at a distance of vertical, we have to draw a line of 20 mm here. This line will be 20 mm. Next, this view, if you see, you can able to see this part, this 6 mm part, and this part you can able to see in the form of a some square or rectangle like this in the top view. You cannot able to see the slant view. So for that one, what I am doing is I have taken the construction line here, the extension projector. I will try to extend the projector up to this one, and then a vertical line here. This vertical line distance will be 24, and again a horizontal line, again this distance will be 20. Okay, the same which it is going to meet at this particular point. Okay, next I will take a connecting line here. This connecting line that I have to take at a distance of 6 mm from this particular point, because 6 mm already we have taken a projector line. We will just join the line. Next, down of 20 mm. Next, a horizontal line of 12 mm, which we can see here. Next, extend this line up to the end, okay, whatever the thing which we are weaving from the entire surface, because up to here we have drawn, and then this part, entire part, we can see in the form of a rectangle, then close it, okay. This will be how much length again, whatever the length which we are seeing from this particular point to this particular point, so it will be totally 44 plus 20, it will be 64, okay. Even we can see here also, 20 plus 20 is 40, 40 plus 20 is 24, 64. Like that also we can draw. So next one is this part visible for me. Is it or not? So at a distance of 44, I will draw a line. Next, bottom surface, I will make a merge. This one also will be again 44. Next, this curve is there, no? This curve is there for us. Curve also we have drawn. So for drawing of this particular curve, we will take from this point, okay? From this point, I will take a 12 mm line, okay? And then at the bottom surface also, I will take 12 mm line. And from this particular point or this particular point, make a center, okay? So after making a center, draw a curve joining the two points. Then that will become my top view, okay? What will be this distance from here to here? It will be 20. So take a compass with 10 mm radius and join a curve like this. So this completes my top view. This is the top view. Next, I have to draw the side view. For the side view, I have to take the projectors first. So I am going to draw the projectors like this. So here they are asking right hand side view, means I am going to see from this side. This is my right hand side, is it or not? So this part is visible, this part is visible, all small small blocks are visible to me. Very carefully we have to draw. First of all, we will take the outer reference line first thing, okay? So outer reference line 20 plus 24 plus 20. Next, a vertical reference line which is going to be joined this height 24 plus 24 plus 32, and this will be 20 plus 24 plus 20. Next, a horizontal line which will be having a distance of again the same distance, and a vertical enclosure. A box I have completed, okay? This entire box I have completed, because major thing is this one only, okay? Next, at a height of 24, I will bifurcate the line. After bifurcating this line, then at a distance of 20 mm from this particular line also, after bifurcating this line, now this 12 mm distance is there, no? So 12 mm distance is there. From here, 12 mm, I will locate a point and I will draw a line here like this. Then similarly on this side also, at a distance of 12 mm for this part, 12 mm, I will draw a line. Next, on the bottom side, at a distance of 20 mm from this surface, this part I am going to represent here. Similarly on this side also 20 mm, this part I am going to represent it here, so that the center will be 24. It is very clear. Next one is, this curve is not visible to me, no? If you see from this view, this curve is not visible, but I have to represent that there is a curve here. So what I will do is, I will try to join a line like this, okay? So at a distance of 12 mm from the base surface, and at here at a distance of 20 mm, take a center. I will take a curve of 44 and join the lines, so that I will get the exact distance. And this completes my right hand side view.